In this video, we're going to be installing the Paragon 20mm wheel spacers for the C8, obviously. I think I have everything I need. There's one thing that I'm worried about, and it's that we're going to have to file down the studs on the inside of the wheel. And hopefully I don't have to do that, but I was sketchy and I just got a little file. I mean, that's what other people have used in the video, but someone else used a Dremel. But I think this will just work fine. So yeah, these are pretty heavy. They're well made. They come with the bolts as well, but they've got the little Paragon branding right there. And they should add like pretty good width on the car. So I'll do a video of what it looks like now. I'm gonna do one of them first and then see if everything works and we'll go from there. Okay, so we finished putting on the spacer on the back right. This is what it looks like stock. So you can kind of tell. It's probably hard to do it justice on video, but that's what it looks like stock. And then on the other side, here's what it looks like with the spacer. And it's crazy how much like 20 millimeters can make that much of a difference. Okay, I feel like that's more than 20 millimeters. But it was pretty tough to put on just because it's like, it's hot outside and it's like just a hard process, but actually doing it isn't the end of the world. You just gotta take off the like painter's tape or plumber's tape that's around the bolts, and then you put it on. Luckily for us, we didn't even have to file down the bolts on here, because there's some cases where you have to file it down. At least for this one, it wasn't the case. It was even easier. So hopefully for the other ones, we don't have to do that, but I think it definitely makes a huge difference. It looks awesome. All right, we have finished the mods. This is a couple hours later after I've finished. So what ended up happening is I did one of the tires or one of the spacers on the wheels, and we had to run a Lowe's to get a 20mm or 21mm like thin wall socket to tighten that on. So we did that. I finished up another one of the rear tires last night, and then I did the two front ones this morning. Just took me like 2 hours. Doing it for the first time is always harder than just like repeating it, obviously, but it was a pretty simple process. I'm gonna link the Paragon performance videos down below in the description so you can check those out and see like the details. But just a couple of really quick rules of thumb that I would just keep in mind if you decide to do this yourself. So first things first are like the tools I used. I just used a 3-ton jack, low profile, long reach. That was a big help. I tried to get jack stands, but they were too tall for the C8. I probably should have looked into that before getting them, but I wanted to be safe. So instead what I did is I had this jack that I got on Amazon that ended up being a completely different thing from what I thought it was. So I ended up, just once the car was actually jacked up with that thing, I put this underneath it just for safe of mind. I mean, everything was fine, but I just did that just to be safe. So that was one thing. The other thing I got was this metal file to file down the nuts on the inside of the wheel. And we actually didn't even end up, we didn't even need to do that, which was like really awesome. We actually got really lucky with that. We didn't need to file down any of them besides this front one, and we tested all of them with the tape method that Paragon shows how to do. So you take the wheel off, lay it down, you tape the insides where the bolt could be rubbing, put it back on, wiggle it around a little bit, take it off, and we didn't see a single marking on that back one, any of them. There was two markings on the bolts on the front right one over there, but everything else was perfect. So that's something to be aware of. Make sure you have the metal file just in case. And then just some like other small things, having a 21mm thin wall socket, big help to actually tighten the spacers on. And then last thing is maybe like a breaker bar just to pop the tires off. I had a crossbar that we were using for the tires and it was good, but some of these were really put on there well. So here is kind of what it looks like. Here's the finished product. You guys obviously would have seen some befores in previous videos and at the start of this one, but I think it looks a lot better and it really makes like a pretty big difference. So you can see the fronts look like that, And what's great is in the previous video, we got these mud flaps, and now it just works perfectly because the wheel is actually coming out to where it should, and the mud flaps are there, so it literally lines up perfect. I love how this thing looks now. It's great. I think like the rear tires are even better. And this is a new tire because I got a nail on this, so I got a brand new tire as well, just like a day or two ago. But here's what the back looks like as well. It ended up working really well, but it was just really hard to put those on. And you can see from up top, look at how that comes over. Usually it's like really tucked in there, and now it's just like perfect fitment. Like even the front, they're just coming out exactly where they need to. Definitely the looking at it from the back is the best. And there they are in there. You can see the spacers. 20 millimeter. See the Paragon logo down there? It's crazy because I don't want to get my hand too dirty, but I can stick my whole hand back behind there and clean that whole rotor, which is awesome. So I wasn't able to do that originally, and now I can. And there's the front. You see the spacer in there, Paragon. It looks pretty good. And same from the front. You can see that. So that's what they look like. Now, two more things, or one more thing I want to show you in here. All right, I got one more mod that I want to show you guys before I wrap this video up. I actually installed these a day or two before the spacers, and that is some more carbon fiber trim here on the side panel. Really solid fitment once again. Like this is some, I actually love how this one looks. Like this really, just a black on white like contrast. Looks awesome. Like I think it's one of the best things. It's so cool in here. We got, I've done this a million times, but I just always do it when I see this. I have carbon fiber here. We got the carbon paddle shifters. We got the gauge cluster in carbon, and we got the carbon trim there. Obviously in the seats stock, it came with that carbon, but adding this extra little bit here, I think it just sets it off so nicely. Now what I'm thinking is for the outside of the car, I'm just about done with everything that I really want to do. I'm not sure what else I want to get done on the outside, but on the inside, I'm thinking about getting some carbon to cover this up, because now that there is carbon everywhere covering up most of the silver, I mean, the only parts that are silver that are left are this right here. I know this is actually a pretty solid part that I can get that could be covered in carbon. We've got this piece right here, which is a bigger piece of silver that's left over. This I know I can cover up. The other big one is the grille speakers. I don't think it looks bad, but I think it would look pretty cool in like a stealth carbon. I don't think I would do black. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. I know I can get both either stealth black or carbon, and they have that even for the Z06. So this is basically as close to a Z06 killer that I can get. I got the Z07 style wing on there. I've got the mods, so it's faster than a stock Stingray. We've got the carbon everywhere, right? We got carbon there, carbon there. Obviously a carbon fiber steering wheel is something I eventually want to get. It looks menacing now, like a Z06 with those spacers, like it looks how it's supposed to. So we'll see what I do next. And so yeah, that's basically everything for this video. We installed the spacers. I gave a little bit of an overview of how to do it, but there are more detailed videos that I'll link below from Paragon. I'd say the biggest thing to just be aware of, it's not an entirely difficult process. Some of the parts can just bog you down a little bit. Like for me, last night when I was taking off one of the back ones, the lug nuts were just on there incredibly tight. I don't have like a big breaker bar. I probably should get one, but I've just got a normal crossbar. Ended up working. I just need to put a little bit of effort and force into it. But that was a little bit nerve-wracking for me because I've just never really done it before like that. So that ended up working fine. Just be aware of that. Make sure you check your wheels with the blue tape method just to check. It's not gonna hurt to check it really quick while you're doing it. And then yeah, just have everything set up properly. Get the tools that Paragon tells you. Make sure you get a thin wall socket for those spacers and you should be good to go. But that's everything for this video. Let me know what you think what other carbon bits you think that I should be getting for the interior, if anything at all. And pretty soon I really want to take this thing to the drag strip, see what times I can set with all the mods that I've got on it. I'm really happy with the car so far. You know, I think I'm so much happier that I got this instead of waiting for a Z06 or even paying over MSRP for a Z06 now,
because it's my own. It's totally unique. Like, my objective, I was talking about this last week with some friends and family. I basically want my Stingray to be like the best modded Stingray out there, at least for me, in my opinion. So I basically want it, like, every time I see another C8, right, or a Stingray, maybe even a Z06, it's like, dang, that they look awesome, right? Every C8 looks great, but I want mine to be like, okay, this is like top tier. This is exactly what I want. No other Stingray out there can beat how mine is spec. That's what I want it to be for me. So I'm really happy with like the process that I've been able to build it, like myself, like build it, right? So that's everything I got. Let me know what else you guys think I should be adding here. And I'll see you guys in the next video. I appreciate you watching. Have a great rest of your day and stay positive. And just, yeah, I'm so happy with the end result that I've got right now. And this probably isn't the end result because it's never gonna stop. I'll probably always wanting to do something. But I think for the most part, we're just about getting to the end of some of the mods. So see you guys in the next video. Talk soon. Come closer, 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 closer. Visions of you.